Good morning, everybody. Today I'm going to be talking to you about a change that I would really like to see happen in the city of Ashtabula, Ohio. Ashtabula is located on Lake Erie and is currently in a state of poverty. Their poverty rate is 33.7% according to the 2009 census. The average income yearly for a household in the city of Ashtabula is $29,566. So, why am I throwing this at you? I just want to start out by saying that because of Ashtabula being a poverty-stricken city, the need for foster care families is high. There is a correlation between the two that I'm going to just briefly discuss. The first thing you need to know is that when a family is considering fostering a child, there is a lot that goes into that consideration and a lot that needs to be done and supported and given to that family in order to ensure that a child is going to have the greatest success with that family, even if it's just for a foster, even if it isn't just for an adoption. So I just want to mention, though, real quick, just in the state of Ohio, there's 14,533 children living in foster family homes. 3,000 of those children are currently waiting permanent homes to actually be adopted. So just so you have a little bit of numbers, that should help you in understanding that the need really is great. The next thing I want to mention, the reason why I'm throwing these numbers at you, is I have an intervention that I would like to discuss. It's a change that, again, I really want to see happen in the city of Ashtabula. My intervention that I'd like to provide is in order to help increase the number of foster families that currently exist in the city of Ashtabula. The number is rather low. There are a lot of children that are still in waiting, and we really need to make this change happen as a community to see those numbers increased and to provide what we can for our children. So the seminar I want to provide, I have created a name for. It's called Homes from the Heart. It's for families who are currently fostering children and for families who are considering fostering children. I'm going to throw some evidence out there that foster families who are currently fostering and those who are considering fostering, according to evidence, do not feel that they are fully supported and do not feel that they are fully prepared when they receive a child into their home. They feel that the training that they might be getting and the classes that they might be taking and all of the certificates that they receive just isn't enough to truly prepare them for what is coming at them when they take in a child into their home. So the point of the seminar is going to be in order to lessen that need for more support and to help these families understand that as a community, we're going to help them out. And as a community, we'd like to see that be better for them as well. So the evidence also supports that there really is a stigma right now when it comes to fostering children in the state of Ohio. There is a high stigma that it can be dangerous, it can be stressful, it can be financially a burden, it can be feeling like you have no support, and overall just really not a good experience for foster families and foster parents. That's not a stigma that everybody believes, but it's a stigma that's out there nonetheless. And I feel that it is strongly a lot to do with why families are not considering fostering right now in the city of Ashtabula. Another thing to mention too is just to kind of bounce back to what I said about the poverty rate right now being 33.7%. Which is a lot to do with why I am talking to you today as the board of directors for this foundation, to really explain to you why we need this money and why something like this needs to be in place for a city that is really struggling right now. So other than the stigma and the poverty level, again, I think it's just important that this seminar were to happen, that this Homes from the Heart is to be created. The entire background and whole purpose of the seminar is not only to provide education in overall dynamics about fostering children and about taking a child into your home, but also preparation, which is important to understand the history and environmental changes associated with taking in a child, which is something I feel that a lot of families are ill-prepared on and need to have better guidance on. There are measures that need to be taken when fostering a child. There needs to be a supportive environment. There needs to be connections. There needs to be communities, you know, support with each other. And when I am to create this seminar, when I want Homes from the Heart to be launched, I want it to be that safe environment. I want it to be that session that a fostering family can come to and say, okay, you know what? I've gained information from this place. I know what I need to do now. I'm more confident. I feel more excited. I feel more ready, and I feel more supported to take on the role of being a foster family and making this change in my household and taking in this child who needs my help. So the whole point of Homes from the Heart, again, is to really provide a person with that understanding and with that hope that they're going to be okay and that they're going to be supported. To go a little bit more into detail, it's a seminar. Homes from the Heart is going to happen bi-weekly, so twice a month. The seminar is going to consist of the same material and the same information that's provided to the families for each session. And I'm doing it this way, I'm proposing it this way, because I would like to see more families come to each session, and perhaps different families come to each session and gain more material and start understanding and learning what they need to learn to become a foster family, and at no cost to them, hopefully. So it's more important that they understand that this is something they can do out of their heart. And that's why I have decided to call it Homes from the Heart, that it's not about being paid to do it. It's not about having to worry about the money to do it, to come to the seminar and pay for it and sit there and learn it all and be tested. It's nothing like that at all. It's all from the heart, so that these families can start to understand that as a community, we just need to step up and make change happen. As a social worker, I want to see more families become more involved in being foster families, because I know there is a need for it, and because I think there's a lot of families out there who can really benefit from it once they start to understand it and start to see that they are supported. And we as a community have to show them that they are supported, which is, again, kind of the whole point of Homes from the Heart. So my expectations of Homes from the Heart, which is, again, the name of my seminar, is I want to measure the data of the increase in foster homes according to what the services that run foster care, like Ashtabula County Children's Services. I want to be able to gain the information from them that there has been an increase in homes and that children have not been sent out of county. That is a big thing for Ashtabula County. When children are not placed in a home within the city of Ashtabula, they are sent elsewhere and they are often sent out of county. And that's something that I really want to see lessen as well. That's something we need to see lessen as a community and keep our children home and keep them here. So, with that said, I have measurement data, I have measurement tools I'm going to use to measure that data and ensure that those changes are being made and that, you know, things are getting better. So I also am going to measure it by seeing an increase in number of attendees for each seminar as well. So maybe there's 10 people for the first seminar, maybe there's 20 people for the next seminar, maybe there's 30. In the event that that doesn't happen and that our numbers somehow decrease or are not as high as I would like them, then I would reevaluate the situation and I would reapproach how I would create the seminar and maybe change some things up. So I want to thank you so much for listening to me today. I hope you consider the proposal I have and that you have seen that there is such a need for this, and that hopefully we can really make this happen one day, and I hope you consider me. Thank you so much.